But there is one more feature. And this feature, a lot of people thought we would never add until this happened. So, I'm here to report to you today that this has happened. Today we are announcing that the second generation iTunes doesn't just run on the Mac, but it runs on Windows 2. Exactly the same thing on Mac and on Windows. This is not some baby version of iTunes or the music store. It's the whole thing. iTunes for Windows is probably the best Windows app ever written. When we set our mind to something, we go all out. And you will see that when you experience it. It runs on Windows XP and Windows 2000, and it is fantastic. But before we even get to the music store, I want to focus on just one thing first. iTunes for Windows is the best jukebox ever on Windows, even if you never use the music store. It's unbelievable. It is a fantastic jukebox. iTunes has always been heralded as the best jukebox out there, and now it's available to Windows owners, Windows users. So let's compare it with the two most popular jukeboxes on Windows, Microsoft's and Music Match. Well, first of all, people want to encode in MP3, not some proprietary encoding. Well, Microsoft's jukebox doesn't even let you do that. Music Match's does, but they cripple it because they slow it way down so it can't encode it anywhere near the drive speed. Well, why do they do that? Because they want to sell you a $20 upgrade, that's why. So you pay them the 20 bucks, then you can encode as fast as your drive will go. iTunes, full-speed encoding, built-in, pristine MP3 encoding. One of the best encoders in the industry. Well, the next thing you want to do is burn CDs. How does that work? Well, Microsoft will let you burn audio CDs, but no MP3 CDs. Music Match will let you burn MP3 CDs, but again, they cripple it. So it runs at a fraction of your drive speed, so you pay them the 20 bucks. iTunes, full-speed, perfect CD burning. Audio CDs, MP3 CDs, and DVDs if you want to back up your music on DVDs. None of the others let you do that. Next thing, you might want to work with the most popular and best MP3 player on the market, the iPod. Microsoft won't let you do that. Music Match will let you put the music you rip off your own CDs on the iPod, but no online music, not even their own. iTunes works seamlessly with the iPod. It's designed to work perfectly with the iPod, so obviously that's a yes. Music sharing is another one. I want to share my music among different computers in my house. My own music on as many computers as I want, my online music on up to 3 computers that are authorized. Microsoft, no way. Music Match, no way. iTunes, yes. Rendezvous music sharing is built right into the Windows version of iTunes, so you can share your music among your Windows PCs and your Macs, back and forth. All works seamlessly. And the upgrade cost to fix a few of these problems? $10 to buy an MP3 encoder alone for the Microsoft jukebox, $20 to uncripple the Music Match jukebox. All of this is built in and free in the iTunes jukebox. Here's an example. This is what Music Match does. They actually let you do a few burns at full speed, and then they tell you they're going to slow you down. At the end of the trial, burning will still be possible, but at a reduced speed. In addition, you'll no longer have access to all the great burning features below. Upgrade now to Jukebox Plus. This is the game that's being played, and we're not playing it. It's all built in. It's all free. Now, another thing about the iTunes jukebox. Our Windows iPod customers have been really telling us loud and clear that the number one thing they want is iTunes. They do not want to use the jukebox we used that we gave them to use on Windows. They want iTunes on Windows. Finally, our iPod customers on Windows are going to get to have the jukebox they want. So, best jukebox on Windows before we even get to the music store. It also happens to be the best music store on the planet. So built right into the jukebox, you just hit on music store, and boom, you are there. The same exact store that is on the Mac. We don't have a Mac store and a Windows store. We have one store, and it's got the same music, the same policies, and the same prices across Windows and Mac. They are identical. And in terms of policies, remember, we are the gold standard for personal use rights. We fought to strike a balance between the rights of the content owners and the rights of the legal users. And we think we got it right, and it's the same as it has been, and now it's on Windows. You own the music, no subscription fees. Unlimited CD burning for personal use. Burn unchanged playlists up to 10 times. Unlimited number of iPods, past, present, and future models. Play your music and store it on up to 3 computers. And you can authorize and deauthorize computers. If you've got 3 computers, you're going to give one away to your school and buy a new one. You can deauthorize it before you give it away. The music will not be playable on that computer anymore. And you can authorize the new one you buy. Again, no one else does this kind of stuff. This is all standard on iTunes on Mac, and now it is standard on iTunes on Windows. You're getting the music store that has a 70% market share and all of these great new features and works seamlessly with the iPod. Now, I said you could put your music on up to 3 computers. You can mix and match those computers as well. You can have Macs and Windows computers all sharing the same music. It's pretty terrific. So, iTunes on Windows. Now, I'd like to do something I've never done before. I'd like to give you a demo on a PC. So, let me go ahead and launch iTunes for Windows. Here we go. And so, let me just go play a few songs. Oh.
Oh, where have you been, my blue-eyed son? And where have you been, my darling young one? Katie, I do believe I failed you.
Of course, we have the visualizer. We have equalization as well.
Don't you know I tried so hard to love you in my way? It's easy, let it go.
So, we've also got smart playlists over here. Here's my 60s music right here, you know? Except that's not 60s music. What's going on? And my top-rated music here as well. We've also got radio stations, all of the iTunes radio stations. Oh, gosh, what do we got here?
When I'm in the lake, the big black snake told the little green frog, said, I'm gonna lay here all day long. I got to rock tonight, baby.
So we got all of our great radio stations, and we've got shared music. I've got a Mac sitting right here, and I can just query, and here's all of that, all of the playlists off that Mac. Again, you know, top-rated music. Here's, you know, stuff from school, whatever it is. And this stuff streams, as you know. Whatever. And so this is all discoverable on a PC with Rendezvous all throughout the house on the local network. It's pretty cool.